Here are some highlights from the bad interview. First of all, the interviewer told personal stories that are not necessary during an interview.
For example, the snake story. The
shovel story.
Yep, with the rats. The interviewer was not knowledgeable about the job.
For example, she didn't know anything about the benefits. And for another example, benefits are not, you know, getting a good tan and being able to work out in the sun on the job.
The interviewer was also on the phone, not paying attention to the applicant, which is a big no-no.
A way to fix that in a good interview, stay off the phone. There was no proper greeting. Stephanie just kind of knocked on the door, and the interviewer just sat here.
With her feet up on her phone.
Yes, not a proper greeting.
There were many close-ended questions that could have easily been answered yes or no, such as...
Have you ever been in the landscaping business before?
Yes or no.
Doesn't give you much chance to express what you have done before.
The applicant was also often interrupted by personal stories, being on the phone, the co-interviewee that was late.
That didn't know that there was an interview going on.
Yes. The interviewer also made the company sound very undesirable to work at. I don't know who wants to work with rats.
Or have bosses that have no idea what is going on in the company. Like, they didn't know that there was a gym. Or, you know, the benefits.
And the interview was often off topic with, again, more personal stories and accounts of rats in the office, which you should probably never tell an applicant.
Yes. So, if you wanted lessons on how to do a bad interview, follow these tips.
Here's what not to do.